Hello, Matananda. Geshiri 6, and this is Toho Makukasai Fantastic Danmaku Festival. Many Toho fan games come from China. I've told you as much during the Let's Play of The Disappearing of Gensokyo. When you ask which of the Middle Kingdom's productions are the most influential, Fantastic Danmaku Festival usually comes up. It's no wonder it got a Steam release in 2018. We're going to play on normal mode. We have the usual suspects, Lazy Remu and Thieving Marissa, but we could also choose Airheaded Sanae and Couch Potato Patchouli. We're going to pick said Couch Potato, not because I'm necessarily best as her, but because she's the most interesting to talk about. Just so you're not confused, I've off-screened the first four stages. My stance is that those are the warm-up phase of any Toho shooter. Stages 5 and 6 are when they shift the action into top gear. One thing anyone is likely to notice first is that this game is beautiful. The backgrounds and the lighting of bullets is excellent, on the same level as what Zun puts out, for sure. Some may even claim the graphics here exceed the original works. Can the same be said about the gameplay? We'll see. We have suffered our first pichoon. It was not the sickly magician's fault, but mine alone. So what is special about her as a playable character? First of all, she is slow. Miss Bookworm will move at a snail's pace. In Danmaku games, this needn't always be bad. A slow ship will move more precisely. The Stage 5 mid-boss is our faithful assistant Koakuma, who seems really exhausted because she was already the Stage 4 boss, and she's one of those types who doesn't know when to give up. Just like an embodiment of Scarlet Devil, Koakuma likes to use large bullet globes, but Fantastic Danmaku Festival adds another theme to her. It is jack-o'-lanterns. Yup, she's the spooky Halloween girl. If she was hoping to get a treat from us, too bad we played a mean trick on her. So what else makes Patchouli unique? In the shoot-'em-up jargon, she's what you call a shotgunner archetype. In most Toho games, you only fire a rapid stream of bullets. You'll deal damage so long as you keep it on your target. Patchouli also has this standard shot, but in addition, she can actively mix in big damage bursts. You may have noticed that we sometimes create a sudden laser or spit out a spread shot of fireballs. Those are Patchouli's shotgun attacks, and you use them by briefly letting go of the fire button after you've held it down for a long enough time. When you resume shooting after each release, you'll hear a pulsating charge-up sound. When that one is at its peak, the next burst is ready. Don't try and use it too early. You'll abort the charge-up and nothing will come out. Getting the rhythm down for this is very important. Sakuya, the perfect maid, is our Stage 5 boss. How peculiar that it was exactly like this in Toho 6. It's actually not peculiar at all. Fantastic Danmaku Festival is literally a reimagining of EOSD with only small variations in cast and story. An example is Koakuma taking on the boss mantle and Patchouli promoting exclusively to playable. All the other characters must also battle Koakuma. So now it's witch versus servant. Sakuya still uses knives and her time-stopping powers, but there may be other surprises. During her non-spells, she zips around a lot, making life hard for the unmoving Great Library. Sometimes so hard that she just quits living. It's difficult to land our laser bursts under these conditions. The fireballs are better for such opponents that are often out of reach. Sakuya's first spell card shows off her other symbolisms, roses plucked straight from Koichi's Freudian garden and Western-style playing cards. Was pretty easy to capture, we did so in only 9 seconds. That's really fast. You see, shotgun archetypes like Patchouli tend to be very destructive. After all, you have to do extra work for your damage. The next spell card is all about quick positioning. Red lines will periodically show up. Act fast and move away from them, because if time stops and you're still on one, you're already dead. It's a really awesome and stylish pattern. I'm now disappointed that I bombed through most of it on this run. Usually, it's a spell card of middling difficulty. The one coming up is much tougher. Occasionally during illusion, uninstant death square, pink kunai will close in on you. You have to head towards them and then curve around. If you just wait and don't move until they arrive, you'll be surrounded and trapped. Good capture, if I'm allowed to say that about myself. Overall, Fantastic Danmaku Festival is not an exceptionally hard shoot-em-up. It's saying something that we have 9 lives in stock. Okay, make that 8 lives. Compared to Zun's work, difficulty in this game would be on the low end. This supposedly wasn't always the case. Fantastic Danmaku Festival is actually an older fan game, I think from 2012 or so. Only the Steam port is recent. Just barely deathbombed there. I often underestimate how fast the first Armored Knight shoots. Anyway, I've heard that the difficulty was slightly toned down for this version, not because anyone specifically complained, but just to make it more accessible for the broader audience. Now who's this lady? Her name is Nyx, and she's a Nyx, a being of Greek mythology. It's actually a creature that Rumia would be somewhat comparable to, and interestingly, Nyx completely replaces Rumia for this title. She is an original character of Team Makukasai, and honestly, she is mostly a smarter Rumia with a different haircut, as even her spell cards are darkness and obscurement themed. The best example for this is Black Hole, Heart of Galaxy. What you're about to see may be confused for a survival spell card, as you, your shots and even the boss disappear when everything's actually still there. The bullets may seem tiny and slow moving, yet they travel awkwardly due to the center whirlpool. They're in fact so irritating that most of the time I don't capture this spell card. So many bats to kill here, they're nicely filling the gauge in the lower left. Completing it sucks up all on-screen point icons and creates life and bomb pieces. It's one of the few special gameplay gimmicks that Fantastic Danmaku Festival uses. For the most part, they're keeping it classical. I do like Remilia's swagger bone ship throne. It fits perfectly to this posh and pompous brat. Unsurprisingly, the young vampiress is the culprit, just as she was in Toho 6. Her scheme this time is not all too different, sending out intoxicating drug gas that makes other demons want to party with her, including popular ones like Nyx. I remember I once read a comment about this game. It was only 3 words, all ending with the letter X. Nyx licks dicks. I know I shouldn't be amused by that. Can't help it, I still am. The remaining spell cards of a boss are always shown in the top left corner. We have 7 blue jewels there. We can expect a lengthy battle, as it should be. A clever and skillful use of our shotgun bursts should cut those many health bars down to size. If you're wondering how exactly our bursts work, when you let go of the fire button while unfocused, it'll be the thin but strong laser. Do it while you are focused, and Patchy will cast her 6 fireballs. You know what Fantastic Danmaku Festival likes to use against you? Scare tactics. Divine Spear, Spear the Gungnir, is a great example. If you stand perfectly still during the spear throw, you'll be safe and you'll only have to dodge the 3 knives that follow. Like I said, it's very typical for this game to make patterns intimidating through sudden, fast, or dense bullets. Often they will slow down or loosen up if you just keep cool and wait. It's a more bark than bite mentality. Now, before Remilia gets really serious, arguably she already is, I have a history of 0 captures for this spell card. I wanted to remind you of something. A reimagining of Embodiment of Scarlet Devil. Doesn't that seem familiar? I have once shown you a video about Uniting Barrage Action, a game nowadays localized as Azure Reflections. I told you back then that it had a lukewarm, not terrible, but also not great reception from the fandom. One moment, what a spell card name. Divine Punishment, Castlevania Break. I don't quite agree with that. I think it should be Bloodstain Break. Anyway, I think I know now why Azure Reflections has this not so stellar reputation. By being a reimagining, not only does it invite a direct comparison with Toho 6, but it'll automatically compete with any other reimagining, this one. Obviously, Azure Reflections loses to both. The better is the greatest enemy of the good. Actually, I have heard people call Fantastic Danmaku Festival the better EOSD. Pretty bold, but it is an exquisite shooter. Too bad, finally lost a life after a long and fortunate streak. We have now arrived at a survival spell card, a real one this time. The bullets alone are very slow, yet Hell's Gate has one subtle danger to it. On screen are 6 faint red lines that periodically blink up. If you sit on them as they blink, you die. If that weren't the case, this would be a really harmless pattern. The way it is, though, Hell's Gate is hell. Don't have to step through, you're already there. I rarely ever capture it. Some of the dodges have been so narrow, I admit, luck was with me, not as much skill. Only 10 seconds remaining. Can we do it? Even then, Remilia's most vicious spell card awaits. It's so frightening, they don't even dare to spell its name correctly. Armageddon Devil Fiesta. Like many final spells in Toho, this one has bomb damage immunity. The tricky part about it is that you need to have your sights on many places. Occasionally, a swarm of bats will home in on you, and they can be very stealthy among the many other bullets. Worse yet, beam pillars shoot up from below. Attacks coming from a completely different direction are always likely to catch you off guard. Overall, this is a really cool pattern for a finale, and it makes one understand why this game gets praised. Fantastic Danmaku Festival received a sequel in 2019, simply called Fantastic Danmaku Festival Part 2. It's another reimagining, this time of Perfect Cherry Blossom. Perhaps it warrants its own Let's Take a Look At one day. For now, I can only tell you it did not disappoint. And that is our 1cc with the arguably overpowered Patchouli in the bag. I'm Geshedi6, this was Fantastic Danmaku Festival, a quality bullet hell that any fan of Zun's work should also try out. Bis bald!